Maryland kicks off the lacrosse season with a big victory over Navy. We're here in the press room in Byrd Stadium, well, Maryland Stadium. It's Bruce Posner and Wayne Viener. Bruce, what'd you see today?
I saw a very good effort, a great defensive effort. Danny Morris was stellar, but it was really the defense that did it. I mean, Bryce Young was out with an undisclosed injury, and midway through the third quarter, Brzozowski was out, and all of a sudden you had Jack Welding in, you had guys who've played but haven't got serious minutes, and yet they played great. They really stung Navy's midfield. They affected their shots. And, you know, I think if there was a time of possession clock in this game, it would be even. But Maryland got much better shots off.
How'd the weather affect the game?
I think it hurt the offense big time. I thought there was a lot of, like, errant passes and some slips. And but, you know, it was for both teams. It was really no big advantage. Navy actually early on just could not figure out Maryland's defense. And Coach Sewell was talking about how no matter what they did, they were on their right hands, on their shooting hands, like in seconds. Navy could not get free. And then all of a sudden, Timmy Rotance led the offense, as we would expect. Connor Kelly, food poisoning last night. I saw right away he wasn't like himself. Still got a goal and assist. Jared was his usual Jared game.
Right.
But it was Bubba, Ethan Mincer. Yeah. We love
our guys. Yeah. You know,
dented the nets. Bubba got a hat trick. First game hat trick. And Logan Wisniewski's had one goal and one assist.
So the power's back. It's not the same team as last year.
Oh, it's complete.
And of course, the Bruce recorded the postgame news conference, and that's available on terptalk.com as well. Meyer Consulting Engineers. In the past 5 years, our organization has completed over 1,300 projects in the U.S. and abroad, including many structures at the University of Maryland. For structural engineering and materials testing and inspection, call Meyer Consulting Engineers. A couple of things that stood out from the presser. One is that Tillman kept reinforcing that it's not the same team, but still the sky's the limit.
Well, if you heard that question I asked Rotance at the end about, you know, is he like the leader? And he wouldn't accept that. I really believe that he is the leader. Him and Kelly are kind of like the guys who set it all up. But he says, we got six guys that we can go to. He said, and I'm comfortable with any of them taking it on their own to, you know, try and score or whatever. Mm-hmm. And we have a lot of weapons. I think the offense is going to be a working project. And, you know.
Yeah, it's coming.
Right. And as the year goes by, and there's a quick turnaround, got a game on Tuesday.
Tuesday, 5 o'clock.
Against Marist. You going to make it?
I don't know about Tuesday. We'll see what the weather's like.
You'll make it. You'll make it. You'll make it. Definitely make it. But face-offs was bothersome.
Right. You said at 1.2 of 7?
Yeah. Well, it turned out that we lost 12 of 18. And Shockey got an attempt.
And
he was over three.
Shockey's the new transfer came
He's
in.
A new phenom. But the guy from Navy, last week the guy was suspended. Their main, I think it's Gorello or something.
We'll check
Vardello, Joe Vardello. Mm-hmm. He was suspended. They lost 19 out of 20 faceoffs, and thus they lost to Jacksonville. This week it was different. Meantime, I know you guys, did you hear about the Furman game?
No, we didn't.
Carolina was up by seven. Seven over Furman. Furman took the lead.
Wow.
Carolina scored in the final seconds and scored in overtime to win.
Brushy hugging people down there again.
Oh, man. I don't know what's going on
there.
So
it's been a good day. We spent the first half of that over at Xfinity Center, Maryland, all over Northwestern. Today,
never a game.
It got down to 5 points in the second half. It got down to 5 points at the end of the first half, and Maryland came back and pushed the lead.
Herder, what did Herder wind up with?
I think it was Mason. Was it 20? 20 points, but he could have scored.
He had 12 after 5 minutes.
Right.
We really went into an offensive drought, it seemed, from the 10-minute mark on into the first half.
Well, they went out of a matchup zone, went to man, cut Maryland's opportunities down, but the Terps overcome that. Here, it's Terps 10-4 over Navy?
10-4, right. One thing I noticed today, and you tell me if I'm wrong, because I was not there. I watched it half-heartedly on TV. It seemed like Checo made a difference today.
Not the first couple times. The last time, the rhythm of the game finally came to him.
Yeah, I thought that he was a factor on there. And Fernando, did he score?
He was phenomenal defensively.
I know that. I saw that.
He got 2 points. There were free throws. He was more of a decoy and a passer than he was a shooter. It was really a guard-oriented attack. And when the opportunities were there, at one point Maryland was 7 for 10 from 3. They got open. They had 8 assists on the first 10 baskets. The offense was working. It stopped, and it came back. I think all keyed by the defense.
Now, listen, I know I tweeted you something or I texted you something. You said I was nuts. On TV today, because I'm watching on YouTube TV, they said that if Maryland wins the game today, which they did, that some gambling service gives them a 47% shot of making the tournament.
It's they just got
now. What's
win
that
the game.
Based on? It's based on winning on the road.
Got to win.
You know, because
at Nebraska.
Who do we play next? We play
at Nebraska, and then Rutgers here.
Okay, we'll know by next week.
We'll know.
We'll know by next week. Bruce, great day. What a great day.
Good day. All right. Nice wet day for our Maryland Turtles. Wayne Viener, Bruce Posner, we will see you on the radio.
On Wednesday.
On Wednesday on the radio, Saturday mornings, Wednesday evenings on 1300 CBS Sports Radio, and we will be back at Xfinity Center. Maybe we'll be here on after the Maryland lacrosse game.
I'll be here.
Bruce will be here, and we'll be on after Maryland plays Rutgers at Xfinity Center next Saturday.
8:30?
I think so. 8:30 Saturday
what if
night.
They start at 10:30. Make it midnight. You know, then do midnight bowling down at the student union. You know,
wonderful suggestion. we will see you on the radio. Good afternoon.
Bye bye.